So first step will be to determine the position between point D and E where our slope is zero. So to determine the position at which your slope is zero between point D and E, we again consider the slope equation. We put this value of slope equal to zero and consider the slope equation up to third partition, which is valid between point D and E. So we get EI into dy by dx, which is equal to zero, equal to minus 6 into x square by 2 first partition plus 7.6 by 2 into x square minus 4x plus 4 second partition minus 10 into x square minus 8x plus 16 by 2 plus 50 into x minus 4 third partition. So what we do is we actually expand this two terms. So upon simplification we get 0 equal to minus 3x square plus 3.8x minus 15.2x plus 15.2 minus 5x square plus 40x minus 80 plus 50x minus 200. So clubbing the x square terms and x terms and constants, we get minus 4.2x square plus 74.8x minus 264.8 equal to 0. So this is a quadratic equation. The root of this quadratic equation is given by the formula x is equal to minus b plus minus square root of b square minus 4ac the whole upon 2a. Now in this equation, our a is minus 4.2, b is plus 74.8 and c is minus 264.8. So the two roots which you get from this equation is x is equal to 12.93. Now we see 12.93 is greater than the span of the beam, hence we discard this value. Next root which we get is x is equal to 4.87 meters. Now we see that this value of x is between x is equal to 4 meter and x is equal to 6 meters, that is between point D and E. Hence, taking this value into consideration, we say that slope is 0 at a distance x equal to 4.87 meter from origin C. Let that point be considered as x. So now we need to determine the deflections at point C as well as at point x, which is between point D and E. So first we take our yc. So now consider this deflection equation. Putting the value of x equal to 0 in deflection equation, since the point C is origin, and considering the deflection equation up to first partition, which is valid between point C and A, we have EI into YC is equal to minus 6 into 0 cube by 6 plus 8. So from this we get the value of YC as 8 upon EI. Now putting the value of EI equal to 1.8 into 10 to the power 4, we get your YC equal to 4.44 into 10 to the power minus 4 meters. Now since it is a positive value, our slope at YC is upward. Next, we determine deflection at YX, where we found that your slope is 0. Now again consider this deflection equation. Now putting x equal to 4.87 meter in deflection equation and considering the deflection equation up to third partition, which is valid between point D and E, we have EI into YX is equal to minus 6 into 4.87 cube by 6 plus 8 first partition plus 7.6 into 4.87 minus 2 cube upon 6, second partition, minus 10 into 4.87 minus 4 cube upon 6 plus 50 into 4.87 minus 4 square upon 2, third partition. By taking the value of EI equal to 1.8 into 10 to the power 4, we have your YX equal to minus 3.31 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. And since it is negative, our deflection at point X is downward.